I think the question from my perspective is, or the exciting thing which climate change has made us do, is to begin to realize that we have to think like natural resource-dependent communities. And natural resource-based and dependent communities have to think about the entire natural resource base where they live. I love that term, you use spaces of survival. Climate change is about our spaces of survival. And too often, we've treated those in kind of boxes. This is the forestry box, this is the water box, this is the agriculture box, this is the science box, etc. Too often, we've created governments in that same structure, we've funded things in that structure, but now we've come to realize that to solve these problems, we actually have to take a landscape perspective. So the issue for me is not so much how does watershed management experience somehow fit into climate change? It's how does climate change and the way we approach it learn from efforts to actually address functional landscapes? And I think we've heard some very important ones here. One of those is without the community being at the core of those activities, without their tenure being clear, their governance systems being recognized, the diversity of each gender's role in that space, their relationship to governments, private sectors, outside powers. Without taking that at the core, we will not address climate change, just like we can't do integrated watershed management. Without a holistic and integrated approach that we heard about, which really links these different sectors together, we won't address climate change. Without drawing on traditional knowledge and then using science in a practical manner, we heard these great examples of actually getting short-term meteorological forecasts back to farmers. How many science products that all of us have been involved in are regularly on a sort of a periodic basis, let's say every month, getting back to some farmer or some landscape user? Not often enough. So there's some very interesting and exciting examples of how we can make technology, scientific monitoring much more useful. Why? Because it has to be adaptive. So again, we know that to address climate change, we're going to have to be adaptive, and we're going to have to be adaptive at scale. And learning from lessons of communities who have managed landscapes functionally for a very long time, and who are now being encouraged to simplify them, to reduce their agricultural systems to single crops, to change to a single monoculture biofuel system, to use all the water once, you know, et cetera. The forces that are out there are actually trying to simplify. And climate change requires complexity. And we heard about that. That's what we learned from watersheds. Complexity, diversification, it's not easy, it's messy. But the more complex it is, the more beautiful it is. We saw a picture of women dancing. So I think we have to appreciate that a functional landscape is something that goes beyond just livelihoods, but it has to fulfill a whole area of improved well-being. But that comes through adding value, through the market, through this food stability, security, and it allows us to adapt to all these changes that we can't predict. And one of the largest ones is climate. I know I've got to end. What I was going to say about financing, though, is that we have to turn around our mindset. If we think that really doing good landscape-level work can help communities be the kind of engine for rural revitalization, and we emphasize that, that rural revitalization will fund those landscapes. So we have to turn it around so that we're generating an economy in the rural areas which is actually significant, and that takes a lot of redirection of current investments, which are all going at a much higher level for much more large-scale approaches that are simple and do not address these problems. So I think it was a very, very useful session for us. I think we have very strong arguments to make for a landscape approach and one that can learn from these. And a friend of mine refers to landscapes, functioning landscapes, as the sort of lifeboats of the future. And this focus on water in this session, to me, really showed that how we need to keep those lifeboats afloat to maintain that those areas of resilience, of complexity, of genetic material, of adaptive ideas, of social innovation. So I'll stop with that, leave it to you.